Hello students, welcome in the next lecture of numerical techniques. Okay, so in the previous lecture we are going to start the new chapter, that is chapter number 3, numerical integration. Okay, so in numerical integrations we have to calculate the definite value of the definite integral by using the tabular values of the function. That is, we have to given that only the pair of values x0, y0 up to xn, yn, and from that data we want to find the definite integral. Okay, and also we can find the function. Okay, so in the previous lecture we are going to introduce that numerical integration. Okay, and also we obtain the general quadrature formula. Okay, and from that general quadrature formula we obtain the first numerical integration formula, that is called the trapezoidal rule. Okay, in quadrature formula if we put n is equal to 1 and taking the second and higher order differences are 0, then we have to get the trapezoidal rule. Okay, so in trapezoidal rule we divide the given interval x0 to xn to equal length by we consider the only one strip. Okay, then in today's lecture we are going to discuss the Simpson's 1/3 rule for finding the numerical integration. Okay, so the Simpson's 1/3 rule, we want to obtain the Simpson's 1/3 rule by using the general quadrature formula. In the general quadrature formula we have to put n is equal to 2 and considering the third, that is delta q, third and higher order differences we have to consider all are 0. Okay, that is we have to consider the 2-2 strips, that is from x0 to x2 on this interval in this way, x0 to x2. Then next we consider, that is we divide closed interval x0 to xn into the sub interval x0 to x2, x0 to x2, then x2 to x4. 4 x up to xn minus 2 to xn. Okay, and for these 2-2 strips we find separately integration, and by taking their addition we want to get the whole integral from x0 to xn, and from that we have to get the formula, that is we name it as the Simpson's 1/3 rule. Okay, so we obtain Simpson's 1/3 rule first, and also then next we want to obtain the next numerical integration formula, that is the Simpson's 3/8 rule. Okay, so I write here the general quadrature formula. We obtain that general quadrature formula in previous lecture. We know that general quadrature formula is I, that is the integration from x0 to xn y dx or f of x dx. Okay, so is equal to nh, h that is the length of interval, h we consider b minus a divided by n. Okay, here b and a that is x0, b that is xn, and n that is we want to divide the given interval into n sub intervals. Okay, n equals sub intervals. Okay, so y0 plus n by 2 delta y0 plus n into 2n minus 3 by 12 into delta square y0 plus n into n minus 2 bracket square divided by 24 and into delta q y0 plus up to so on. Okay, which is the general quadrature formula. Then in this general quadrature formula, in this general quadrature formula, we put n is equal to 2, n is equal to 2, and take third, that is delta q y0, and take delta q y0 and all higher order forward differences, all higher order forward differences will be 0. Okay, so this formula becomes a general quadrature formula becomes, by putting n is equal to 2 we have to get I is equal to integration, here we consider x0 to xn, and for n is equal to 2 we get here x0 to x2 y dx is equal to For n is equal to 2, we get here 2h in bracket. Y0 will be as it is plus n, take it as number 1, then n will be here 2, that is 2 divided by 2, delta y0 plus, by putting n is equal to 2, here 2, 2 into 2 becomes a 4, 4 minus 3 divided by 12, delta square y0. And here we want to consider the delta cube, that is third order, and all other higher order differences will be 0. So these all other terms we have getting all are equal to 0. Okay, so it's equal to, we get 2h in bracket y0, 2 to divide, gets cancelled, delta y0, that means by using definition, which is the difference of y1 minus y0, okay, plus here 4 minus 3 will be 1, and here 2 6 are 12, that is 1 by 6 delta square y0. Okay, then again we write here formula of this delta square y0, this y1 minus y0. In this plus y0 minus y0 gets cancelled, and here we write the formula in bracket delta square y0. Formula of delta square y, value of delta square y0, I directly write here y2 minus 2y1 plus y0. We find the second order differences in previous chapter. Okay, so we directly here write the value of delta square y0, that is the second order forward difference. Okay, so by simplifying this, we have to get here 2h in bracket this y1, y0, y0 gets cancelled, plus 1 by 6 in bracket. Okay, so here if we take 1 by 6 outside, 1 by 6 by taking outside, to get here 2h divided by 6 in bracket here 6y1. Okay, because here we take 6 outside, so this y1 will, so 6 will be multiplied by this y1, so 6y1, and here remaining terms will be y2 minus 2y1 plus y0. Okay, so we have to get here 2 3s are 6, that is h divided by 3, in bracket we have to get 6y1 minus 2y1, we get 4y1, that is y2 plus 4y1 plus y0. Okay, bracket complete. So we have to get, this is the integration from x0 to x2 y dx, take it as equation number 2. Okay, so we have to get the integration of the function for this x0 to x2, for this in sub interval x0 to x2. Okay, so similarly in this manner, if we find the value of the integral again for the x2 to x4, that is for n is equal to 2, we consider the 2 strip at a time, and then by comparing with this, we have to get the next value integration of this function on the next strip. So similarly integration of f of x on x2 to x4 is, by comparing with this, we have to get integration from x2 to x4, that is we consider here 2 strip at a time. So we have to get, comparing with this, here h by 3 will be outside, and here we have to get the y2 plus 4y1 plus y0, that is value of the function at point x2 plus 4 times value of the function at point x1 plus value of the function at point 0. H by 3 will be outside. Okay, so by comparing with this h by 3, and here we want to get, here will be x0 to x2, so here from x2 to x4, so we have to get here y4 plus 4y3. In between x0 to x2, the value of the argument will be x1, so 4 times value of the function at that point. So here in between x2 to x4, value of the argument will be x3, so value of the function at that argument, that is y3, so 4y3 plus y2. Okay, so in this way we have to get the integration on the second strip x2 to x4. Okay, and take it as equation number 3. Similarly, if we find the integration on the last strip, that is xn minus 2 to xn y dx, then we have to get is equal to h divided by 3 in bracket yn plus 4 yn minus 1 plus yn minus 2. Okay, so take it as a equation number 4. We compare with these terms to write these terms for this interval xn minus 2 to xn. Okay, and then lastly, if we add all these integration, that is from x0 to x2, x2 to x4 and up to xn minus 2 to xn in LHS, then we have to get the integration from x0 to xn, and in RHS, if we add all the term, then we have to get the Simpson's 1/3 rule, that is the formula. Okay, so we take their addition and add equation number 2, 3, ... and up to 4, that is all equations, to get integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to integration from x0 to x2 y dx plus integration from x2 to x4 y dx plus up to integration from xn minus 2 to xn y dx is equal to, we have to get the terms in RHS h divided by 3. See here, again in all the term contains h divided by 3. So we take directly here outside from the RHS. So h divided by 3, and in bracket we write all the terms. So y2 plus 4 y1 plus y0 plus then y4 plus 4 y3 plus y2. Okay, then plus up to this last yn plus 4 yn minus 1 plus yn minus 2. Okay, bracket complete. That is, we have to get is equal to h divided by 3. Here y2. Okay, so see here, if we observe here the second, that is all the even arguments x0 to x2. Here x2 to x4 integration we take. Then xn minus 2 to xn. That is x2 x2 becomes here repeated. So term of y2 will be becomes a repeated here also and here also. That is, we have to get the 2y2. Okay, because we consider here the two strip at a time. So we have to get the all even ordinates, that is all the even values of the function at values, all the values of the function at even points, that is y2, y4 gets repeated. So we write here that will be added 2 times. And here y0, see here, y0 we have to get only 1 times. Okay, term of y0 we have to get only 1 times. Also term of, that is value of the function at point xn, that is yn, term of yn also we have to get only 1 time. So y0 and yn will be at only 1 times. So we write that in first, that is y0 plus yn. Okay, then we have to get the all value of the function at all the even arguments will be 2 times. So we write here 2. Here we have to get this y2. Then again in this term also y2. Again if we find here the next term, then here also y4. We have to get in next term also the term of y4. Because we take the next integration from x4 to x6. Again from x6 to x8 in this way. Okay. So we have to get 2 times in bracket all the even ordinates. That is first even, that is y2 plus y4 plus up to, we have to get up to y minus 2. Okay, so in this way, for that term the integration will be considered as xn minus 2 to xn minus xn minus 4 to xn minus 2. So in this term also yn minus 2 will be present. So these 2 times becomes a 2 times. So we take all from all these term 2 outside directly, that is in this way 2y2 plus y4 plus up to yn minus 2. That is we have to get in Simpson 1 by 3rd rule all the even terms becomes a 2 times. So 2 times the all even ordinates. Then if we observe here all the odd ordinates, that is y1, y3, y5, y7 up to so on yn minus 1. All that odd ordinate, all odd ordinate multiplied by here 4. So we take 4 outside or the from all the odd ordinates. So we have to get here 4. See here 4y1, then 4y3 and up to 4yn minus 1. So we take 4 outside. So in bracket we get y1 plus y3 plus up to we have to get yn minus 1. And then bracket complete. So we have to get, this is the Simpson's 1 by 3rd rule. Here 1 by 3 will be outside, that is h divided by 3. So name it as the Simpson's 1 by 3rd rule. Okay. Integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to h divided by 3. H, that is the length of interval. Okay. Then in bracket addition of extreme ordinates, okay, plus 2 into in bracket addition of all even ordinates plus 4 in bracket addition of all odd ordinates. Okay, so you can easily remind this formula in this way, that is by taking remaining word. Okay, so h by 3 addition of extreme ordinates, that is if we have to give one the interval y0 y1, that is ordinates y0, y1, y2, y3 and y5. So by this formula we have to get, formula will be h divided by 3 in bracket addition of extreme ordinate, that is y0 and y5, extreme ordinate 0 plus y5 plus 2 times addition of even ordinate. Here even ordinate will be only 1, so 2y2 plus 4 in bracket addition of odd ordinates 4y1 plus y3. So this is the Simpson's 1/3 for 1/3 rule for this ordinates y0, y1, y2, y3 and up to y5. Okay, so in this way the formula will be implemented. Okay, so this is the Simpson's 1/3 rule. So using the Simpson's 1/3 rule we can determine the value of the numerical integration. Okay, then next we want to obtain the Simpson's 3/8 rule. Simpson's 3/8 rule by using the again general quadrature formula. So by obtaining Simpson's 3/8 rule using the general quadrature formula, we want to put the n is equal to and n is equal to and taking all 4 and higher order differences will be 0. So we have to get the Simpson's 3/8 rule. That is we have to consider the integration on the interval at considering the strips. That is from first we have to consider integration from x0 to x3, then x3 to x6, then x6 to x9 and up to xn minus 3 to xn in this way, and by taking their addition to get the whole integration. Okay. So put n is equal to 3 and take 4th and all higher order differences, forward differences will be 0. Okay, so by putting here n is equal to 3, we have to get integration I is equal to integration from x0 to xn, but here n is equal to 3, so we have to get x0 to x3 y dx, okay, is equal to n, n is equal to 3, so we have to get here 3h in bracket y0 plus 3 divided by 2 delta y0, okay, plus n will be 3, so 3 in bracket 2 into 3 will be 6, 6 minus 3 divided by 12 into delta square y0, okay, plus by putting n is equal to 3, so 3 in bracket 3 minus 2 will be 1, we write here 3 minus 2 bracket square divided by 24 into delta cube y0, okay, and all other terms becomes gets to 0, okay, so is equal to 3h in bracket y0 plus, here by putting value of this first order divided difference, that is delta y0 will be y1 minus y0 plus 3, 6 minus 3 will be 3, so 3 into 3 becomes say here 9 divided by 12, okay, into delta square y0, again we write here formula of delta square y0, that is value of the second order divided difference will be second order forward difference, not divided difference, sorry, y2 minus 2y1 plus y0, okay, plus 3, 3 minus 2 will be 1, so 3 divided by 24, that is we have to get here 3, 1 by 8, okay, then value of delta cube y0, we write here in bracket, that is y3 minus 3y2 plus 3y1 plus y0, okay, bracket complete. Then by simplifying this integration from x0 to x3 y dx is equal to 3h divided by 8, sorry, 3h in bracket y0 plus 3 by 2 y1 minus y0 plus here 9 divided by 12. If we divide numerator and denominator by 3, that is 3 3s are 9 and 3 is a, so we have to get here plus 3 divided by 4 in bracket y2 minus 2 y1 plus y0, and last term will be, I write here y3 minus 3y2 plus 3y1 plus 1 minus y0 bracket complete. Here also will be minus y0, not plus, okay. So is equal to expansion, that is the third order difference will be same as the expansion of a minus b bracket cube, okay. So is equal to, if we take, see here, if we take, here will be 1 by 8, will be missing, so 1 by 8. If we take from all the terms, 1 by 8 will be outside, then we have to get is equal to 3h divided by 8. So in bracket, here 8y0, here absent, so multiply it by y0, so y 8y0 plus, here will be 2. That is if we divide and multiply here by 8, okay, so by taking 8 outside and here these 2 4s are 8, so we have to get here 4 into 3 will be 12, or that is 12 in bracket y1 minus y0, okay, then again plus, here also if we divide and multiply by 8, okay, so this, if we take this outside, 8 outside, then 4 2s will be 8, so 3 into 2 will be 6, 6 y2 minus 2 y1 plus y0, and here already 1 by 8 is present, we take outside, so remaining only y3 minus 3 y2 plus 3 y1 minus y0, okay, so in this way we have to get the terms, so is equal to 3h divided by 8 in bracket 8y0 plus, by separating these brackets, 12y1 minus 12y0 plus 6y2 minus 12y1, 6 into 2, 12 minus, sorry, plus 6y0 plus y3 minus 3y2 plus 3y1 minus y0. Okay, so we have to get 3h divided by 8 in bracket. This plus 12y1 minus 12y1 gets 0. Okay, then 8y0, we take addition of y terms of y0. 8y0 here minus 12. 8 minus 12 will be minus 4, and again here plus 6, plus 6y0, and last term will be y0. Okay, plus 6 minus 1, minus 4 minus 1 will be minus 5. 6 minus 5, that is we get only y0. So in bracket here y0, then we take the addition of all y1 terms. Okay, so these plus 12y1 minus 12y1 gets cancelled, then remaining term of y1 will be only 3y1, so plus 3y1. Then terms of next terms of y2 and y3. Okay, so here terms of y2 will be 6y2 and only minus 3. 6 minus 3, that is we get here 3y2, and term of y3 will be only this, so plus y3. Okay, so we have to get the integration on this strip x0 to x3. Integration from x0 to x3 y dx is equal to this. Okay, 3h divided by 8 in bracket y0 plus 3y1 plus 3y2 plus y3. Okay, we take x0 to x3 for this interval x0 to x3. So we have to get 3h divided by 8 will be common, and in bracket we have to get the addition of the value of the function at the point x0 plus 3 times value of the function at point y0 plus 3 times value of the function y x2 and plus at the point x. So again, if we take similarly, if we take integration similarly for integration on the next strip x3 to x6, okay, by considering 3 strips at a time. So x3 to x6, for this interval we have to get x3 to x6 y dx. It is equal to, by comparing with this, 3h divided by 8 will be outside. I can directly write from this. Okay, so we have to get here value of the function at this lower point, so that is y3, plus when in between the two arguments are x4 and x5, so this will be 3 times, so 3x4, that is 3y4 plus 3y5 plus last argument, that is y x6, and at that point value of the function will be y6. So comparing with this, I can directly write this. Okay, so take it as number 2 and number 3. Similarly, continuing in this way, if we find the value of the integration on the interval xn minus 3 to xn, okay, then we have to get similarly continuing in this way to get integration for xn minus 3 to xn, for this interval, that is xn minus 3 to xn y dx, is equal to 3h divided by 8 in bracket value of the function at this lower argument, that is yn minus 3. In between two arguments are yn minus 2 and yn minus, sorry, in between two arguments are xn minus 3, then next argument xn minus 2 and xn minus 1 and then xn. Okay, so 3 y n minus 2 plus 3 y n minus 1 plus last argument will be xn. So value of the function at that will be y. Okay, so take it as a number 4. By taking, okay, then by taking addition of all these integration, we have to get the integration from x0 to xn. Okay, so take addition of equation number 2, 3 and 4 to get, I write here, whole integration x0 to
x n y dx is equal to x0 to x3 y dx. By taking addition of all these, then x3 to x6 y dx plus up to xn minus 3 to xn y dx is equal to, I write here, addition of RHS. Here if we observe, all the term contains 3h divided by 8. So we take outside. So 3h divided by 8 in bracket. 0 plus 3 by 1 plus 3 by 2 plus y3. Then next, y3 plus 3 by 4 plus 3 by 5 plus y6 plus up to last yn minus 3 plus 3yn minus 1 plus 3yn minus 2 plus yn. Okay, then by simplifying that we have to get the integration, that is the formula for finding the numerical integration, that is Simpson's divide rule. Okay, so 3h divided by 8. Okay, so here if we observe, the first and last argument, sorry, not argument, the first and last ordinate, that is value of the function at first and last point of the interval will be unique at one time. So we write their addition first, that is y0 plus y. Okay, then if we observe here, the terms multiple of 3, that is y3, because here we consider the integration, we consider the three steps at a one time, so we have to get the ordinates, that is y3, y6, y9, that is multiple of 3 will be 2 times. Okay, that is here will be y3 by 3 2 times. Then again for the second term y6, and if we write the next term, then we have to get again first term of that will be y6, that is we have to get again 2y6, again 2y9, again up to 2yn minus 3, that is multiple of 3 terms, that is ordinates multiple of 3 we have to get 2 times. So we write that directly 2 in bracket multiple of 3, that is y3 plus y6 plus up to here yn minus 3. Okay, then plus, here we take 3 outsides and the remaining terms, that is in all the term contains the 3. So we take 3 outside and write all the terms. So 3 in bracket y1 plus y2 plus y4 plus y5 plus up to yn minus 1 plus yn minus 2. Then bracket complete. So this is the Simpson's 3 by 8 rule, or which is called the Simpson's 3 by 8 rule. Here the 3 by 8 will be multiplied for this formula, so name it as the Simpson's 3 by 8 rule. Again we write the Simpson's 3 by 8 rule for remaining, we write in words. So I is equal to integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to 3h divided by 8. Simpson's 3 by 8 rule, so 3h divided by 8 in bracket again first addition of extreme ordinate y0 and yn will be the extreme ordinate, addition of extreme ordinates, ordinates that is the value of the function at the extreme point. Okay, then in bracket, okay, then plus 2 times addition of 2 times addition of multiple of, addition of multiple of 3 ordinates, 2 times addition of multiple of 3 ordinates plus 3 into remaining, 3 into remaining ordinates. Okay, so in this way we write the formula in words, that is the Simpson's 3 by 8 formula. Okay, for reminding this formula we can remind in this way, that is by writing in words. Okay.
So in Simpson's 3/8 rule, we put in general quadrature formula n is equal to 3 and take fourth and higher order differences to get the Simpson's 3/8 rule. That is, we consider the three steps at a time, x0 to x1, x1 to x2, x2 to x3. That is x0 to x3 in this way, then x3 to x6 and up to xn minus 3 to xn. Then we have to get the data, that is the Simpson's 3/8 rule. You can use easily this formula to find the numerical integration. Okay. So in next lecture, we solve the example, that is to find the numerical integration by using these three rules, trapezoidal rule, either trapezoidal rule, Simpson's 3/8 rule or the Simpson's 1/3 rule. Okay. So today we will stop here. Thank you.